Have you ever wondered how two siblings who could have the same mom and dad can still look so different? Well, today we're going to talk about the process that makes that possible, a process called meiosis, not to be confused with mitosis, which unfortunately sounds very similar. You may also have heard people pronounce meiosis as meiosis. We've been guilty of that, but technically if you look up the pronunciation, meiosis is the correct one, so we'll stick with that. Meiosis is a process that contributes to the variety, so we're going to jump right into it. You might remember that humans have 46 chromosomes. That's how many all of the body cells in your body have. But there's some cells in your body that don't have 46 chromosomes. Human sperm cells and human egg cells actually only have 23 chromosomes. Why? Well, think about it. If a human sperm cell has 23 chromosomes and a human egg cell has 23 chromosomes, when they come together, that makes 46. That will now allow a new developing fertilized egg to develop into a human. Meiosis is all about sperm and egg cells, or if you want to get really fancy, gametes. Gametes is definitely the fancier word. Meiosis is what we call a reduction division, because you have a starting cell that has 46 chromosomes, in humans, and your ending cells only have 23 chromosomes. So it's reduced, it's a reduction division. And in its production of sperm and egg cells, the cells are going to be all different from each other. In males, remember males make sperm, all the sperm cells are going to be different when they're produced. They're not identical cloned sperm cells. This whole process is really different from mitosis. Mitosis was really great when it was going to repair damage or worn out cells. Mitosis was really great for growth because mitosis makes body cells. You know, mitosis has to make identical cells. Like when you have a cut and you have these damaged skin cells, you have to replace them with identical skin cells. That's what mitosis was all about. Meiosis is not about making identical cells. The cells that meiosis makes are not identical, and they're going to be sperm and egg cells. Now, before we get into these stages of meiosis, we have to remember what comes before meiosis. This actually also happened in mitosis. It's that stage known as interphase. If you remember interphase, it's when the cell's growing, it's replicating its DNA, it's carrying out cell processes. Just like mitosis, interphase happens one time. So it happens before meiosis is going to start. And you might remember from mitosis that little phrase PMAT. The P was for prophase, the M was for metaphase, the A was for anaphase, and the T was for telophase. And the good news is, in meiosis, you will still use those terms, so that's great. But because meiosis is actually a reduction division, you're going to divide twice. You're going to do PMAT twice. So we're going to go through it so that it's going to make more sense. Here's the good news, though, about PMAT happening twice. In meiosis, the stages have numbers after them. So there is no prophase in meiosis. There's a prophase 1 and there's a prophase 2. And there's no metaphase in meiosis. There's a metaphase 1 and a metaphase 2. So there's a number, and that really helps it stay straight. So let's start with the very first step, prophase 1. One thing I like to remember about prophase is the word pro. If you're talking about the Greek root, it actually means before. So it kind of helps you remember that it comes before all the other stages. This is where the chromosomes are going to condense and thicken. They're actually going to line up with their homologous pairs. The word homologous means that the chromosomes, they're approximately the same size and they contain the same types of genes in the same locations. So they're going to match up. And it's during prophase 1 that this amazing process occurs. It's called crossing over. Now, I know crossing over probably sounds like something very different, but this is actually a really neat process because when these chromosomes are lined up in homologous pairs, they have this way that they can transfer their genetic information and exchange it between each other. It makes for recombinant chromosomes, which can contribute to the variety that we mentioned, that siblings, even if they have the same parents, they can be different. Well, this is a process that contributes. Next, we move into metaphase 1. I always like to remember the M for middle. In metaphase 1, the chromosomes are now going to line up in the middle. It's a little different than how it is in mitosis, though, because they're still in pairs. They're homologous pairs, so they're not going to be in a single file line. Next, anaphase 1, think A for away or for apart, because this time the chromosomes are going to move apart. And then we end with telophase 1, where we end up with two cells. So this time you can think of the T for two, at least for now, at the end of meiosis 1, because you will end up with two cells. However, we're going to end up with more than that in meiosis 2. So the very first step in meiosis 2 is prophase 2. We're not doing interphase again. Interphase only happens once. And prophase 2 is not going to be as eventful as it was in prophase 1 because they're not going to have those homologous pairs and they're also not going to be doing any crossing over. So that's done. You have your chromosomes and the spindle starting to form, but it's just not nearly as eventful of having the process of crossing over. In metaphase 2, again, remember M for middle, the chromosomes are going to line up in the middle. This time, though, they are in a single file line. So it is very similar to mitosis. They are not in pairs like they were before. Anaphase 2, again, remember A for away. This time, though, it's actually the chromatids that are going to be pulled apart. Chromatids are getting pulled apart to opposite sides of the cell. And in telophase 2, remember, we had two cells that we're going to divide. So now, if they both divide, we are going to end with four cells. Now, keep in mind that meiosis is designed in males to produce sperm cells and in females to produce egg cells. And because of independent assortment and crossing over, you're going to have variety. So for example, in males, the four sperm cells that are produced each time, they're all going to be different from each other. And they're going to be different from the original starting cell because that original starting cell had 46 chromosomes. And in humans, those ending sperm cells only had 23 chromosomes. So they are not identical to the original and they are not identical to each other. That contributes to variety. Also, just something to think about. Scientists are often looking into the process of meiosis because sometimes those chromosomes, they don't separate correctly. It's called non-disjunction, when maybe a cell receives too many or too few chromosomes because they do not separate correctly. This can contribute to some genetic disorders, which is something scientists are often studying, and when we get to genetic disorders, we'll talk about that relationship with meiosis. Well, that's it for the Amoeba Sisters, and we remind you to stay curious.